We only have a handful of decades to determine the future of our planet.
A new study tells a tale of two Earths. In one, humans are able to rein in global warming and stabilize the relatively comfortable conditions of the last 12,000 years.
In the other, global warming and climate change cause seas to be 30 to 200 feet higher. Weather patterns are pushed to the extremes, and parts of the planet, like tropical drylands, become uninhabitable.
The second scenario is known as Hothouse Earth. In it, temperatures would be irreversibly warmer than pre-industrial levels by 4 to 5 degrees Celsius or 7 to 9 degrees Fahrenheit.
But what would get us to that point?
To answer that question, 16 researchers surveyed data about the Earth's current and past climates.
You know, like what our planet was like over the last 15 million years.
The study, published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, identified 10 feedback loops. These are natural processes that keep the planet cool by capturing carbon or muting its warming effect.
These include forests acting as carbon sinks or Arctic ice reflecting the sun's energy, and have so far helped control carbon's influence on global environments.
But given enough warming, some of these feedback loops will start to break down and could actually accelerate climate change.
For example, if all the world's permafrost were to melt, that would spew methane, the most potent greenhouse gas, into our atmosphere and exacerbate global warming.
Climate scientists already knew about feedback loops, but this is the first ever analysis to show how their tipping points are related.
Like dominoes, as one feedback system tips, it could trigger enough warming to cause the others to fail.
Some systems might tip gradually. Others, like the conversion of Amazon rainforests to a savanna landscape, would be rather quick.
And changes like the melting of the East Antarctic ice sheet would be impossible for our society to reverse.
So are we headed for the apocalypse? Are we all extras in our own Hothouse Earth blockbuster film?
Not quite. Yes, the study suggests that once we get to a Hothouse Earth state, it will be too late to return to our current Earth system.
And yes, we've already encountered an average global temperature rise of 1 degree Celsius in the last 200 years. That spurred hotter wildfires, rising oceans, and melting ice sheets.
But at the moment, none of the feedback systems have tipped beyond repair, and the scientists believe humanity still has time to park the planet in its current climate system.
That, they say, will require keeping warming below 2 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels.
If humans can reduce emissions,
and focus on things like natural and engineered carbon storage, reduce consumption, and rein in population growth,
and do it in the next few decades,
we might be able to extinguish this hothouse before it burns up. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Seacon Akpan.
And I'm Julia Griffin.